Hello and welcome to the product presentation of our new multiport module from IFM. My name is Christoph Stratmann and I'm product manager for IO-Link input and output modules. Since a long time, IFM offers a huge range of IO-Link master modules. These IO-Link master modules has a very high IP protection. And due to that, the system of the IO-Link master is also a wiring system. So we can mount the master direct into the machine, direct into the field. And it is not necessary anymore that we have to mount a cabinet. So we can save a lot of money. When we have a look into such a modular system, we see that an IO-Link master can read the process data values, the process values from IO-Link sensors. So we can measure temperature or pressure or flow or what else. And the master gives this information to the PLC. An IO-Link master is also able to read the status information of a digital input. And he's also able to switch a digital output to control an actuator. But to read a single digital information, IO-Link master port is too expensive. So in the past, we expand an IO-Link master with our digital input and output modules. That means we connect one module, let me say an IO-Link input module, to one master port and one output module to another master port. And then we are able to collect the digital information from a lot of sensors. And we are able to control digital actuators. But in small machines or in small modules or parts of a machine, we have not always huge numbers of digital inputs and outputs. Sometimes we have only two or three digital outputs. And then it is not necessary to have really a big output module to control only these few numbers of outputs. That was the reason why we design now a new module. It is called multiport module. This multiport module is a free configurable module. The customer can decide how he wants to use each port, each connector. He can use the port as a digital input, or he can use the connector as a digital output. And what is absolutely new in the market, we make the first time the combination of analog information and digital information. Okay, let us have a deeper look into this multiport module. We can also say multifunction module. This multifunction module is an IO-Link device and it will be connected over the IO-Link port to an IO-Link master. But we need also an auxiliary power, a separate power, what must be connected here in this separate connector. And then the multiport module has 8 connectors, 8 M12 connectors. And in each connector we have 2 pins, yeah? Pin 4 and pin 2. Pin 4 is always digital input or digital output. The customer can decide how he wants to use it as an input or an output. New is now the pin 2. Pin 2 can also be a digital output, but it is also a so-called multiport module. The customer can decide if he wants to use it as a digital input Or if you want to connect an analog sensor to this port, he can connect a 4 to 20 milliamp sensor, and he can also connect a 0 to 10 volt sensor. But how must the customer make the configuration of this port? How can he define if this connector will be used as a digital output or an analog input? How can he do this? And for this, we have two possibilities. Some PLCs are not able to handle a configuration tool, and they are not able to make an acyclic communication. For this kind of PLCs, we offer the first possibility. That means that the port configuration will be done with the process data output. When we have a look to this process data output, we see that we have in the last 8 bytes for each port 1 byte. And in this byte, the PLC defines the functionality of each port. And in the response of the multiport module, the multiport module gives a feedback, and the module writes also in the last 8 bytes the actual configuration. So is the PLC able to control that the module is always working in the right configuration, that there was no fault in the communication. That is one possibility. And the unit is set up in this kind of communication when you put it out of the box. But you can make also a change. Yeah, you can change to a standard acyclic parameterization. For that, you have to use a parameterization tool like the line recorder. In the line recorder, you have to read first the standard configuration of the module. And after that, you can search in the search window after the actual possible article number. And when you write down the article number, you see here in the list all available device IDs and all available IODDs. Here you can then select the IODD for the acyclic parameterization. And when you select this IODD here, you have to store this information into the module, and after that, the module will be able to make the configuration over a standard acyclic parameterization. Yeah, let us have a look on a live presentation of this kind of parameterization. For that, we start the line recorder. And here, first, you have a look on all the parameters you need for the standard parameterization. But in this case, we want to look how it works to make the configuration for the different ports. And for that, we change into the cockpit. And I think you know it from all our actuators and from our signal tower. On the right side, we have the possibility to select all the different values what we can transmit over the process data output. And I start here with port 1.1, and I select the functionality 0.1. That means that I want to set up this port as a digital input and digital output. I write this configuration to the multiport module, and after that I can control the digital inputs and digital outputs. For the demonstration, I use this capacitive sensor. I connect this sensor to port 1.1. And when I activate now the output, we see that the LED inside of the sensor or of the capacitive button will be illuminated. And I can switch on and switch off. But I can also see the status of the sensor. For that, I start cockpit 2. And here I can see the digital information of the input. In the next step, I want to connect an analog 4 to 20 milliamp sensor. I go to this point here. I select the drop-down menu, the version 4 to 20 milliamp, and activate the transmission to port 1.3. When I connect the sensor, I can see in cockpit 4 the analog value. And I see here in input 1.3 that the input is changing between 4000 and 20,000 micrograms. That means 4 to 20 milliamp. That is the analog information we receive from this sensor. And at last, I want to connect an analog sensor with a 0 to 10 volt interface. I want to connect this sensor to port X1.5. Here I select the version 0.4. That means 0 to 10 volt. And I write this to the module, and we can connect now this pressure sensor will deliver 0 to 10 volt. And when I have a look on cockpit 4, I can see here a measured value between nearly zero and 10,000 millivolt. That is the analog information from this pressure sensor. The IFM want to present a complete new product family. We will have different variations of these modules. On the left hand side, we have all the modules who are able to distribute digital and analog information. On the right side, we have modules where you can make the configuration only as a digital input or a digital output. We have the orange versions, the orange housing for the standard industrial automatization. And we have the gray modules for the food and process industry. Then it depends on the external power supply. We have versions which need an external power connector. In this version, we have a galvanic separation between the auxiliary power and the IO-Link communication. This galvanic separation helps to have a constant and good IO-Link communication. Then we will have modules who are connected to a B-port master. In this B-port master, we have also IO-Link communication and auxiliary power, galvanic separated, but in one connector. That is handled by the IO-Link B-port master. And at the end, we can connect some modules direct to the IO-Link A port. That means we don't need an auxiliary power. The complete module is supplied out of the IO-Link A port. But here we have to take care that we have a look on the power consumption. An IO-Link master port can only Ja, distribute 1 amp load. And that means that this A-port modules are only able to distribute maximum 1 amp in total. So I hope that you can see that we have a huge range of modules in the future, a lot of modules for different applications, for different connectivities, so that you will find a right module for the right application. I hope that I was able to show you the flexibility of these new multiport modules, and I want to say thank you for your interest. And if you have any questions, please call us. We want to answer all your questions. And I want to say thank you and goodbye.